everyone! In this video you can watch me create a large resin geode on an artboard. And I will be adding structure using different supplies. And I must say that I had a hard time getting this geode the way that I liked it. So you will see it change a lot and you will see my struggle. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin, in this case, but I also have tutorials of acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink, and a lot more tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because if you select all, then you won't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I already started with adding some acrylic crystals onto my artboard, and I'm using a hot glue gun for this, because then I know for sure that the acrylic crystals will stay where I put them. And I'm using different sizes of acrylic crystals. These are clear acrylic crystals in an irregular shape. And I have some open spaces, and in these open spaces I will be adding acrylic crystals that I make myself in a silicon mold. There you can see it. This is these crystals I made earlier, but these are only to fit if they fit in the space that I leave open. But the colors of these crystals are not the right colors. I will be making some purple ones, because this geode will get different shades of purple. I will be also adding some real quartz crystals, and these are very large. There you can see it. Again, I'm using the hot glue, but first I fit them in the space, and then I take my hot glue and glue them to the surface of my artboard. Yeah, and I'm going to show you steps of the process, because I have had a lot of material, video material, and if I would use it all, then I would have a video of more than an hour, so I don't want to do that. So I'm only going to show you steps of the process, but enough so that you can see what I'm doing. Yeah, and I really had a hard time getting this geode the way that I liked it. So you will change, you will see it change a lot. But I wanted to show you anyway, because for me also it's not that easy. Sometimes it looks easy, but I have some struggles to getting something right that I like it. So I'm almost done with the acrylic crystals. Then I'm going to go to the next step. So I'm going to pour the first layer. I'm starting with the Resitint Max Titanium White next to the acrylic crystals. A thin line, there you can see it. Pushing it with my steering stick against the acrylic crystals. And this artboard is 40 by 60 centimeters, and I bought it and it was already primed, so that was great. I taped the sides and the back so that I can remove the resin drips much easier. The next color is a mixture of the Resitint Max Mulberry. It's a very dark purple color, and I mixed in some titanium white so that I get a lighter shade. Very thin line. And the resin I'm using is the ArtPro resin from the Resin Pro company. It's a medium viscosity resin. I like that very much, so not thin as water. Because if I use a thinner resin, then the colors will bleed too much into each other. And I don't like that. So the next color is again the titanium white. Yes, and I also will be adding different structures to this resin geode. Not only acrylic crystals, but also other supplies. This color is from a German company. It's a nice copper. All the links to the supplies you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box. So also all the colors I've used, you can find in the description box below this video. Now I'm blowing out the copper on top of the purple and white. Again, the mixture of the titanium white and the mulberry next to the white. Let those colors bleed into each other. And now I'm using one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the Crocus Magic. So a nice sparkle in it. And again, another shade of purple. This is the Blue Jasmine, also one of my pigments. And this is only the base layer. So this will get more resin layers, but also structures on top of it. Again, a thin line of the copper. And white next to the copper. And for one layer, I needed about 600 gram of resin. Yeah, it's a large artboard. Again, the Blue Jasmine. And some copper next to it. And this copper has the... Yeah, it will also, as the gold as I use, normally use, it will flow, or it will rise to the top. And then it flows like, yeah, it looks like copper leaf, very nice. Adding more white. Heating it with my heat gun. Trying to blow the white on top of the purple colors, there you can see it. To create some nice effects. More white. And those colors go very well together. The purple and the copper. also a copper line next to the acrylic crystals. Some white. And if the colors leak a little bit under my acrylic crystals, then I don't mind. I like that. The crocus magic again. And the blue jasmine. If you're interested in my natural mica pigments, I have listed 65 colors in my Etsy shop. So the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. And it's much cheaper for you all to order from her shop instead of mine, because the shipping costs for me to the USA or Canada are very high. So the link to her Etsy shop is also in the description box. At the moment I'm testing more new colors, so in a few weeks I will be adding more nice interference colors, but also some nice sparkly colors. Very excited about that. Again, I want to blow out the copper on top of the white, not too much. The torch for the air bubbles. And for now I'm done with the first layer. Need to let this dry before I can work on it again. So you can see I've decided to make the whole bottom part white because I didn't like it. And now I will be adding some structures on top. This is the copper color again, and I've added it to the high build resin from Eli Gem. It's a very thick resin, so a high viscosity resin, so where you put it, it will stay. So this will be a very high build up line of copper. Hope I explained that well enough for you to all understand. There you can see it. It doesn't spread to the side. It will stay where it is. Also, here a line of the copper with the high build resin. Yeah, and this resin is perfect to make nice lines, also for your glitter lines or for dots, because they don't spread to the side. Now I'm adding a glitter line with some Cosmic Shimmer Rose Copper. And again, I use the High Build Resin and I've added it into a Ziploc bag. I cut off the tip and now I'm making my lines where I want them. And another color, this is also a Cosmic Shimmer Glitter in the color Lavender. Again in the Ziploc bag, because that way you can make your lines very nice. Also next to the copper, a glitter line. And I'm making it a little bit thicker, this line. And next to the acrylic crystals. You can already see that I've added one resin crystal in the space that I was open, and it's in a color very light purple but also a little bit of pearl white. So the other space that is still open, there will be a darker purple crystal in it, but that one is not ready yet. So also some glitter dots with the High Build resin. I can see it. Also some copper ones. And so far it looks okay. Also some smaller dots. And then I'm almost done with this part of my geode. Well, I need to let this dry before I can work on it again. So in this part of the video you will see me add bronze crackle paste. So if you use this crackle paste after a few hours, a cracks will appear, so the color underneath will shine through. But after I did this, and I had some cracks, but I didn't like it. It was too dark, but I wanted to show you this anyway, because also I have some struggles. It looks, when I make a video, it looks very easy. But I also make mistakes, so I wanted to show you anyway. So this crackle paste is very nice. That's not the problem, but it doesn't look nice in this diode. So this will change for sure. Also in this part some crackle paste. But so you can see, it looks way too dark for this nice geode. I'm so sorry for my friends Bulldogs. They are all the time I do the voice over, they are so loud. So hopefully you don't hear it that much. The rest of the geode looks very nice. Now I'm adding heat to create the cracks. But you can also leave it as is and wait for it. But I'm using my heat gun. And the cracks appear, that's not a problem. So the paste is great, but not in this geode. I don't think it looks nice. So I will be changing it for sure to make it lighter or another structure. So I've decided to add another structure, and this is made from plaster of Paris and an acrylic binder, so next to the crackle paste, to make it lighter, because I think the crackle paste looks too dark. I'm adding this kind of structure, and I will add the link in the right corner in which you can see how I make the structure of texture paste out of plaster and an acrylic binder. So with my spatula, I am adding this paste. We are a little bit further in the process. You can see I've added more to it. Also on top of the copper color, because I want to create that look of a real stone. And of course to make it a little bit lighter. And this is a really cheap texture paste that you can make yourself. Again, a little bit further in the process. It gets lighter, but I'm still not satisfied with the look of the crackle paste. So this is the struggle I'm also having sometimes, because for me it's important that I like what I make. So I've decided to color the crackle paste. You can see it already. I've used the Lumiere Super Sparkle, and now I'm using a nice purple gilding paint on the edges to make it, yeah, to blend it with the Super Sparkle, the white color. I've also added some acrylic lines, so you can see in the purple some thicker lines, some thinner lines. And I didn't show you that all because in other videos I've shown you that before. And I'm always using the Posca markers, the acrylic Posca markers. I like them very much. So now you can see me blend those colors together to match it with the other purple colors I have in this geode, and to cover up the crackle paste, the bronze crackle paste that I didn't like. So all the supplies I've used also for this you can find in the description box below this video. And this is a really nice sparkly white color. But also the gilding paint that I'm using, the purple one, is also very nice. So at the end of this video in a close-up you can see it much better. And I've also added some texture paste on the outside of the geode, on the edge. Now I'm adding some acrylic crystals, and these are 6 millimeters. And I've colored them myself with an alcohol ink in a nice pink color. But I'm also using some clear acrylic crystals and some super shard glass glitter in the color pink silver. Yeah, you can color your acrylic crystals yourself if you only have the clear color. Then you, what I always do is I'm adding clear acrylic crystals in a Ziploc bag, and I'm adding a few drops of alcohol ink in the color that I want. So in this case I've used the pink color. And then you can make your own colored acrylic crystals. I will let them dry, and then you can add them in your resin, because the alcohol ink will not bleed into your resin anymore because it's dry. So on top of the crackle paste I'm adding these acrylic crystals with some glass glitter mixed into it. And I'm liking it much better now. And you can also see that I've added the second resin crystal in the open space I had. It's a darker purple color. Also on the edge of my acrylic crystals I'm adding this mixture. Now you can see it. And to make this mixture I put all the acrylic crystals in a paper cup with some glass glitter and a little bit of resin. And then you can add it to your art piece. Yeah, also on top some of the acrylic crystals, there you can see it. And in this part of the video I'm going to show you how I add the clear layer of resin, because I need to seal in those acrylic lines that I've added on top of the purple.
Because otherwise you can scratch them off. But I think it looks much better now. So what I did next to the crackle paste, I colored it. You saw it all with a purple color, purple gilding paint, and some nice sparkly white color. But I also colored all the other texture with the same colors. Yeah, you can't see it that well now, but in the close-up hopefully you can see it all. That it has a nice sparkly white color on top, and in some places a little bit of the purple gilding paint. So now I'm going to start on the clear layer of resin. And also this way you can create some depth. So I will be adding it on also on top of the texture paste that I made out of plaster and an acrylic binder. But I think it looks much better now than what I had before with the brown or the bronze crackle paste. Let me know what you think of it. If you liked the bronze crackle paste more than it how it looks now. Yeah, and it has a lot of depth also because of the high build resin, because the dots are much higher, and also the bronze lines I've added and the glitter lines looks really nice. And again, I'm using the Art Pro resin for the clear layer. Don't forget my promo codes. I have 3 promo codes at the moment. You can find them all in the description box below this video. Some nice discounts. And also the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box, where you can buy my natural mica pigments, and also the link to my associates Etsy shop for the USA and Canada. So if you are interested, please check out the description box. So on top of the acrylic crystals, also some clear resin, and on the texture paste. And I already know that it will not totally be flat. That's also not my goal. I like structure and textures. And for this clear layer of resin, I've used about 600 grams. Yeah, it's a large resin geode, so then you need a lot more resin. And with my stirring stick, I push the resin against the structure paste, making sure that every area is covered with resin. And I've also, need to mention this, I've also added some nice white iridescent glitter on the acrylic crystals, but also on the copper lines. And I've used a polymer medium and I mixed in that glitter and I've added it to the places that I wanted. Because if I add it in resin, then it will flow where it goes. And then, yeah, it will come in places that I don't like. So that's why I'm using a polymer medium and mix it with the glitter. And the polymer medium is a kind of glue. And I let it dry and after that I add a clear layer of resin. Also some clear on the edge on the texture paste. Spreading it with my stirring stick. Yes, and this is a very long video, so you can fast forward if you want, because this is not that interesting. But I get a lot of questions from people that ask how I add a clear layer of resin. So that's why I'm showing you this also in this video. The torch for the air bubbles. And this is the end result. I have it outside in the daylight. I'm so sorry for the reflection. But I'm trying to show you the glitter that I've added. The iridescent white glitter. And I'm very pleased with the end result. I'm liking the crystal part much better than I had with a crackle paste. The texture is great with a plaster. A little bit closer now. There you can see that I colored the texture paste with a nice sparkly white and in some places some purple. It's so difficult to film this, but I'm trying. There you can see the acrylic lines. The acrylic crystals in the middle, there you can see the real crystals, the pointy crystals, and the crystals I made myself in a silicon mold. Some nice effects there. A little bit closer, there you can see it, the resin crystals. Also some lacing. And I've added also a line of a copper gilding paint, but I'm very pleased with the end result. The texture paste again on the outside. And the glitter lines that I made with a high build resin. Yeah, here I'm trying to show you the depth, but it's so difficult. So if you like what I'm doing, please consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. I appreciate it a lot and it will help my channel a lot. All the information to the supplies I've used, you can find in the description box. Also the link to my Etsy shop, and the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Shaver for my natural mica pigments. And if you want to follow me on Facebook or Instagram, also those links are in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!